Hi, this is Ruth Diaz with Chicago 3 Media. We are at the Hard Rock Hotel covering a very special event tonight. So you might wonder what the event is about. Of course, we have a rock band right here, but he's not. He's actually a doctor, correct?
Yes, that's correct. I went to Rush for medical school.
Very good. Dr. Nadeed, actually, he's an internal medicine, correct? And they are here for a very, very good cause. And he's going to tell us everything about it right now. What's the cause tonight?
For two children victims of the Haitian earthquakes. And one had the arm severed and one has a colon perforation. So we're raising money to get them here to have surgery in America.
Absolutely. What a great cause. And tell me, how long have you guys been playing in the band?
Well, my band is about 10 plus years old. Dr. Ivankovich is about 25 years old. They're the Chicago Blues All-Stars. They're actually the number one blues band in the world on Reverb Nation.
Oh, wow.
And yeah, and I've been playing all over the country, Hollywood. I played the Whiskey last fall. I played the Shrine here in Chicago. I'm here. I'll be in Dubai in November for the Grand Prix.
Oh, that's wonderful. And as you guys know, January 2010, there was an earthquake, and there was a lot of victims left behind. And there's still people in need of surgery. And right now, they have about 11 victims that are trying to fly in here. Depending how much they're going to raise tonight, how many patients are you guys thinking on flying to Chicago to have this procedure?
Well, Dr. Ivankovich has already had success with several that the building fell on them and their spine was crushed and he operated on them and they're walking. So he's had prior experience of bringing them. The real problem with Haiti is that they have good doctors, but all of them died from the earthquake itself. So they're short supplied, you know, under facilitated. And there's no way to have access to these services. People are just out on the street. They don't even know who to talk to, right? They can't. So because water and phone lines aren't there. So Dr. Ivankovich finds these people, and he's built a network, and then he brings them to Chicago, Northwestern, RIC, what have you, and then, you know, rehab them. It's a long, arduous process. It takes 6 months to a year at least.
And we're here with a great woman, Carla, and she's actually the executive director of this organization. How are you?
Hi, I'm fantastic. Thank you for coming out to this evening's event. The goal of this program is to be able to provide assistance for those in need, whether here in Chicago or abroad. The intention is to give 10 women the ability to have functional independence and have their life back. And you see by the turnout this evening, we'll be able to do that.
So we're here with Kathy from the Haitians Congress. How are you?
Fine, thank you, thank you.
So you actually flow in for this event or you actually live in Chicago?
I live in Chicago by Evanston, and I've been working with Dr. Ivankovich, you know, since the earthquake.
Okay.
You know, I'm a surrogate mother of one of the patients that he gave life back. And we're very pleased to be here tonight to support his effort because his passion is to give the Haitian people life, to make sure they can live, you know, a full life and they can walk again.
And we're here with the man of the night, Dr. Dan Ivankovich. How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling very sure. What about you?
Well, I got my high heels on and I've got a very silky lavender leopard skin thong on, so I'm feeling very good tonight.
Okay, great. No, he's a doctor. He's actually... tell me about the organization overall.
In terms of the Blues for Haiti?
Yes, absolutely.
Well, Blues for Haiti is an endeavor that we started on our return from the first relief effort in Port-au-Prince. And one of the things that we worked very closely with the Haitian Congress and many of the Haitians that we still are actively treating in Port-au-Prince, they said, don't forget us. And it's a very important thing. During the earthquake, everybody wanted to go over. For the 3 months after the earthquake, everybody wanted to go over. But 2+ years later, you know, we got to keep this in the media because there's so many things fighting for attention. Corruption, elections, bad economies. You can't forget that there's a lot of people that are displaced in Haiti that do not have access to medical care. And in the case tonight, there's 10 women that are amputees that never receive prosthetic limbs, and they're essentially handicapped. So we're trying to change lives tonight.
What a great cause, and so great to have you. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Dominic Gaziano is actually receiving an award tonight. And I am here. I have the honor to have him right next to me. And also, how are you? What's your name?
Hi, I'm Heidi Pearson.
She's Heidi Pearson. Now, Harry, you are actually part of the organization, correct?
I am. I am the publicist, actually, for Dr. Dominic Gaziano and also for the QGHI.org organization.
Absolutely. Congratulations on your award, by the way.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Can you tell me a little bit about the organization and also the award that he's winning?
I'm sorry, can you say that again?
Can you tell me about the organization? How long you guys been together?
Yes, QGHI is an organization that basically does health initiatives to provide assistance for Haiti earthquake victims. And it's an award that honors doctors that have served and shown exemplary activities and benefits in the community to help individuals that are from disenfranchised communities and whatnot. So, yeah.
So, Dr. Dominic, how long have you been involved with this organization?
Well, I got involved in this organization about the last 2 months. I've been working with these doctors for about the last 8 years. And I was inspired when I sat down to Dr. Ivankovic, who takes care. I was more empowered, but he takes care of a great portion of the poor community. And we sat down to organize this event and to help. I was going to support this event. And I found out I was more empowered when I hear that he does the same kind of work. And we hadn't sat down because we're both busy doctors. And so, and it's just more rewarding when you don't look at who you're treating, but you know you, and maybe I gotta work a little harder, see a few more patients, but you make it work.
Help for humanity is the purpose. Music is the inspiration. This is Ruth Diaz with Chicago 3 Media.